Admission of a partner is a type of reconstitution, because when a new partner is admitted into the business, the existing agreement, that is existing partnership deed, will come to an end, and we have to enter a new partnership agreement. Okay, so an admission will lead to the reconstitution of the firm. So when a firm is reconstituted, what are the changes that will happen, or what are the accounting treatment to be done? Okay, in this chapter we will study these accounting treatments. Okay, so when a new partner is admitted into the business, he will get two rights. That means the first right he may get is right to share future profit or losses. When a new partner is admitted into the business, he will get a right in future profit or losses. Okay, and second right he will get is right in the share of assets of the firm. Okay, he may get some share in the assets of the firm. So these are the two rights he will get, that is right in share of profit or losses and right in share of assets of the firm. Okay, and in order to get these rights, he has to bring something. And what are the things he has to bring in order to get these two rights? Okay, first, to get right to share of profit or losses, in order to get the right, he has to bring a portion of goodwill. That means he has to bring his share of goodwill. Okay, that means if he is getting 1/5 share, then he has to bring 1/5 portion of the total goodwill. Okay, and the goodwill, the valuation of goodwill, we already studied in chapter 2, and we can calculate 1/5 of that goodwill, and he has to bring that amount into the business. Okay, and to get the right in share of assets of the firm, the new partner has to bring some amount of capital. Okay, so to get right in the share of assets, he has to bring capital. Okay, so in order to get these two right, the new partner has to bring share of goodwill and capital into the business. Okay, and in this chapter we will study what are the adjustments that we have to make while a new partner is admitted into the business. Okay, so there are 5 adjustments. Okay, and among this, 4 adjustments we have already studied in our previous chapter, change in profit sharing ratio. There is only last adjustment we will study this chapter. Okay, and the first adjustment is change in profit sharing ratio. Change in profit sharing ratio means, suppose I will give an example. A and B were running a business in the ratio 3:2. Okay, a new partner C is now being admitted. So when a new partner is being admitted, we have to give some share of profit to him also. So suppose C will get 1/6. Okay, then the new ratio will be 3:2, 2:1. Okay, and we will study how this ratio is being calculated. Okay, this is the treatment. So there will be a change in profit sharing ratio among the partners. Okay, and some partner may be sacrificing and some partner may be gaining. Okay, and we will discuss how to calculate these ratios. Okay, then second note, valuation adjustment of goodwill. Next treatment is valuation adjustment of goodwill. In chapter 2 we have studied how the goodwill is valued. Okay, we have studied 4 methods: average profit method, super profit method, and capitalization of average profit and capitalization of super profit. We have studied that. And adjustment of goodwill. Adjustment of goodwill we also studied in chapter 3. That means we have studied 2 journal entries, That means gaining partner's capital account, debit to sacrificing partner's capital account. This is adjustment of goodwill. Okay, we can discuss these adjustments by doing the problem. Okay, then third adjustment is revaluation of assets and liabilities. This also we have studied in chapter 3. Okay, when there is any change in profit sharing ratio, we have to revalue all the assets and liabilities. Okay, then fourth is adjustment of reserves, profit or losses. Okay, when there is any change in profit sharing ratio, all the reserves, profit or the losses is to be shared by the partners in old ratio. Okay, we will discuss again in this chapter also. Then last new topic for you is adjustment of capital. Okay, there are two adjustment of capital in this chapter and we will study it in continuation. Okay.